I can dance. Okay. We good? Okay. Ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, BayPath trustees, honored guests, faculty, staff, and alumni of the university, welcome to today's inauguration ceremony, celebrating the sixth president of BayPath University, Sandra J. Doran. Please take your seats. The processional is ready to begin. Now entering the hall is our color guard, led by Matt Smith, Assistant Professor of Computer Science and Cybersecurity, proud member, veteran of the United States Navy. Joined by Lynn Pellerano, BayPath alumna from the class of 2011 and an MBA 2013 graduate, former president of the Alumni Association and trustee, very proud United States Air Force veteran. And BayPath student, Amaya Jones, in the class of 2023. Leading the processional is our parade marshal and mace bearer, Dr. Thomas Minella, chair of the faculty. Please welcome the full-time faculty of BayPath University. Thank you. please welcome the executive staff, deans, and senior leadership of the faculty of Bay Path University. Please welcome the University, College, and Higher Education Association delegates who are processing an order of the year as indicated in the charters of their founding. Please. Kenneth O'Connell, Harvard University, Scott Foster, Yale University, Tracy Prentice, Princeton University, Janie Wilson, Salem College, Carrie Cullen, Nichols College, Jackson Daly Wilson Jr., Wake Forest University, Susan Monks, Colby Sawyer College, Tiffany Espinosa, Mount Holyoke College, Denise Brown, Framingham State University, Linda Thompson, Westfield State University, Joe Long, American International College, Leocadia Zach, Agnes Scott College, Robert Zomick, Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts, Marissa Kelly, Suffolk University, Martha McKenna, Lesley University, Thomas O'Reilly, Pine Manor College, Lynn Pascarella, American Association of Colleges and Universities, Robert Johnson, Western New England College, Patricia Rissmeyer, Emmanuel College, Harry Dumay, College of Our Lady of the Elms, Brian Bicknell, Manchester Community College, Christina Royal, Holyoke Community College, Jose Perez, Brandeis University, John Cook, Springfield Technical Community College, Maria Altobello, Labore College, Luis Pedrea, Quinsigmon Community College, Howard E. Horton, Cambridge College, Robert Loesch, Episcopalian Divinity School. Now entering is the Bay Path University Board of Trustees. Up here. I now welcome the members of the inauguration platform party who include the Honorable Richard Neal, Mayor of Springfield Dominic Sarno, Jonathan Bessie, Chairman of the Bay Path Board of Trustees, Margaret McKenna, President Emerita of Lesley University, who will deliver the inaugural address, Dr. Carol A. Leary, President Emerita of Bay Path University, and members of our community who bring greetings on this celebratory day. Stephen Doran, presidential spouse, and the sixth president of Bay Path University, Sandra J. Doran. While you're all standing, please continue to stand for the playing of the national anthem and remain standing for the invocation. Provide the invocation for today's ceremony. Thank you.
In 1995, St. Mary's Church, located across from Bay Path University, was honored to host the investiture ceremony of the fifth president, Dr. Carol Leary. Today, as the current pastor of St. Mary's, I'm honored, and St. Mary's is honored to be present and to witness the investiture of the sixth president, Sandra J. Doran. With this said, I invite you to please bow your head and let us pray. Almighty God, we gather this morning as students, faculty, staff, administration, guests, national and local leaders, friends, and neighbors of Bay Path University to formally welcome President Doran. We ask your divine guidance this day and your protection in the days to come. As President Doran leads the Bay Path community with wisdom and courage, may she feel your Holy Spirit assisting her and guiding her. Bless her with countless moments of laughter and joy while doing the serious work of educating students to thrive. Walk with her each day at the university, and in small ways make your divine presence felt as she leads and listens to those on campus. Bless her personal family too, as they support her vocation as the sixth president of Bay Path University. May she also know that we, her friends, her colleagues, her neighbors, are praying for her each day. We ask at this as your children in faith. Amen.
Thank you, Father CJ, for that meaningful invocation. Y'all said. I have to start with, wow. Look at this. We are here together. We're here together as a Bay Path University community, and we've waited a long time for this day. So to start, I actually want to do a quick round of applause and welcome each and every one of you for being here today to join in on our celebration. This is a special day for our university. And speaking of celebrations, it actually is a day of celebrations. I think if all of you know, this is our 125th year anniversary. And if there was any benefit from COVID, other than not having to drive to work every day, and not having to put on pants every day, not having to shower every day, the other benefit was that we were able to combine our two wonderful celebrations, our inauguration and then our 125th gala tonight. So let's be clear, this is a day of celebration in Bay Path style. So we're gonna be loud, we're gonna be proud, we're gonna celebrate, we're gonna have fun, and the celebration will not stop until the last song is played tonight, and maybe not even then. So everyone have an awesome day. I introduce myself. My name is Jonathan Bessie. I'm the chair, privileged to be the chair of the Board of Trustees. And before we get into our main comments, I actually want to do a special recognition and welcome to some of our special guests and groups that are here today. I'd like to start with two gentlemen who really need no introduction, but are tremendous friends to our university, the Honorable Richard Neal and the Springfield Mayor, Dominic Sarno. Gentlemen, thank you for being here. You are tremendous friends to our university. Your leadership to the region and to the nation is much appreciated, so thank you. Next, I'd like to recognize and welcome my friends, my fellow Board of Trustee members. Can I ask current and former board members who are here, can you all please stand up? This is an amazing group of dedicated and talented people, and they are the backbone of this university, and I am proud to work with each and every one of them every day. So thank you all for all that you do. So if they're the backbone, let's talk about the heart and soul. The heart and soul of our university. I want to talk about our faculty. I want to talk about our staff. I want to talk about the executive staff. I want to talk about every single person who maintains our buildings, maintains our grounds, make sure that our students have all that they need, get them in the door, help them get settled, find them careers, everybody that's involved in supporting our students in the way that we want them supported. And that takes a village to do that in the way that we want it to be done. And in one humble man's opinion, we have the best village on the planet. So I want to thank you all for all you do and how you do it. But none of that matters without our students. So while maybe the faculty and staff are the heart and soul, our students are our inspiration. And we have students here today. And I want you all to know, while this day is a celebration for our new president, make no mistake, and I know you would join me in these comments, that without your courage, your commitment, and your inspiration that you give us every day, all that we do doesn't matter. So thank you all for all that you do, and thank you for choosing Bay Path and putting your faith in us. So thank you. Next, we're gonna spend time today talking about our present and our future, but again, none of that would matter without our past. And let's talk about our most recent path prior to Sandy, and that would be the 25 years of amazing and inspiring leadership that we had from our fifth Bay Path University president. So can we do a warm return welcome for our fifth president, Dr. Carol Leary. So I mentioned community before. Well, community is also family. And the reason this day is so special is because Sandy's family is here with us today. So we have her husband, Steve, her children, Dana and Adrian, her daughter-in-law, Elizabeth, and the rest of her family. And we want to give you a warm Bay Path welcome. So thank you for being here. Now, Elizabeth, my understanding is you traveled here and you're 9 months pregnant? Okay, so we have two doctors on the board, possibly a couple of our students and our PA, so we have you covered. But I was thinking, at Bay Path, we love to have memorable events. So can you imagine? Okay, I'm not going to go there. As I mentioned, it's important to understand your past. And our past actually started right here in Springfield, just down the street. As a child, I grew up in northern Maine, small town up on the Canadian border. And one of the things that my grandfather used to say is, no matter where you go in this world, always remember where you came from, and where you came from will always remember you. And we took great pride in where we came from, and my fellow maniac Charlene can attest to that. And so in the spirit of that, I am greatly honored, and it seems so appropriate that our first speaker is actually from our original home here in Spreaker, the longest serving tenured mayor of Springfield, the number one cheerleader, and as I said earlier, a tremendous friend to our university. Please welcome to the stage Springfield Mayor Dominic Sarno.
Thank you, Jonathan. Jonathan, thank you very much. Elizabeth, relax. I do have our brave and men and women in blue here, so if something should occur to upstage your mother, we'll be ready to go. President Doran, Sandy, and to Steve, and you talked, Jonathan, about music. I think the appropriate song probably would be the Etta James tune of At Last. Finally, you're going to be your inauguration installment as president, sixth president of Bay Path University. It's also great to see my dear friend, Carol Leary. We go way back, and we're partners in Love Letters Play to raise money for City State. So, Carol, it's so great to see you and say hello to Noel, too. Appreciate that. To Congressman Neal, to the Board of Trustees, to the faculty, staff, and students of Bay Path, to the honored guests that are on stage, it is right to come back home, back to your roots. 125 years ago, Bay Path started in the city of Springfield. And they've never forgotten that connection, though. Never forgotten that connection. Now, I know it's been a tumultuous 2 years as we move to defeat this COVID-19. And isn't it so good to be back together again, be able to hug, be able to handshake. And, Steve, I don't know if you know, but your wife was also an aviator. Because with COVID-19, we were all flying the plane as we were building it. So as we continue to move forward, and just last week, last Friday, we opened up at the Mass Mutual Center, the Women's Conference, which has drawn tremendous speakers from all across the world. You had Tyra Banks that was here, very successful again. And I'm going to continue to work with President Doran as we continue with innovation and partnership, not only with Bay Path and the city of Springfield. So we're so happy that you're here. And we're installing you as you go into your third year. But today and tonight is your day, and I wish you good health and continued success. And thank you for continuing to partner with the city of Springfield. God bless you all and good health. Thank you.
Thank you to Father CJ and Reverend for the rain to stop and the sun.
Amen.
A politician never gives up the mic. I have the distinct privilege and pleasure. Once a mayor, always the heart of the mayor. Congressman Richie Neal, Chairman Neal, Ways and Means, has never forgotten his roots. He continues to deliver, not only for the United States of America, but for his district, and I know he's delivered for Bay Path. He will wax very philosophic when it comes to history. We are here in this beautiful, majestic Symphony Hall. Richie, as we affectionately and respectfully call him, has been a friend to each and every one of us. Anytime you need anything from the federal level on down, Richie has been there. He's been a great friend to me, a great partner for the city of Springfield, myself. Put your hands together for our friend, our Congressman, Richie Neal.
Reverend clergy and President Doran, Mr. Mayor, trustees, students, faculty, and members of the BayPath University family. So if you're wondering what would occur to me while I was sitting here with that marvelous introduction from our esteemed mayor, I actually voted as a member of the city council to renovate this building. I took the oath of office as mayor three times on this very stage, as well as accepting my high school diploma here some years ago. So for me, just to see the beauty of Symphony Hall, a reminder of those Italian artisans that had such a profound influence on the construction and the history of our community. I thought I would offer beyond a greeting, just a reminder, because as our neighbor to the north, the late Archibald MacLeish, pointed out, the time was famous for its ironies. 2 years ago, on March 11th, Dr. Fauci, who has done a great job, Dr. Fauci, he issued his warning about what was to come. The Bible calls it pestilence. And at that time, 22 million American people within 60 days had lost their jobs. And when you talk about the optimism that this occasion reminds us of, when you talk about what an inauguration means, how important it is for elevating the national conversation, we're also reminded about the resiliency of the American people. So here we are. All 22 million jobs have been returned, and 11 million more awaiting applications, which is part of our challenge today. And in conversations I've had with the president, she understands this dutifully. That alignment of skills and challenges that have been brought about by globalization, technology, it's transformed the workplace. But there's a difference in American life between being trained and being educated. And the fullness of this occasion, I think, makes the argument for being educated. There's a great argument that's ensuing across the country as well right now. It surprised me, as I mentioned to Lynn Pascarella, who was the president of Mount Holyoke when I was a member of the Board of Trustees there, this argument about the value of a college education. It's had more legs than I thought that it would have. I thought it would be a statistical analysis that would come and, like many of those moments, go. But we're also told, when you look at the result of our recovery here in America, how well college-educated members of our nation did. Where the unemployment rate currently stands at 3.6%, it's never been lower because of college graduates. So let's push back against this argument that you don't need to go to college. I understand the argument about how much college we need, but there's a corresponding response, and that is there's always room in our nation for the college educated. When I was thinking of President Doran and of Carol Leary before, who we also had a great relationship with, and I was reading the narrative that was so carefully developed, because part of our story is always telling our story, and what caught my attention was the description of how the president saw the future, again, guided by optimism. But I always use occasions like this to remind people that there's a great offering that also comes from Steve Jobs on occasions like this. He was asked about his success, and he wasn't a very easy personality. He was asked about his success, and he was asked by Walter Isaacson to sum it up. Steve Jobs said, "We've got to show people what they're going to want." In this university and the BayPath family, what a great job you've done during the time that I've been in public office of showing and telling people what they're going to want and what they're going to need. Madam President, congratulations from the United States of America.
Thank you very much, Congressman Neal. It's now my distinct pleasure to introduce Suzanne Parker, the Executive Director of Girls, Inc. of the Valley.
Thank you, Charlene, Congressman Neal, Mayor Sarno, and all of the esteemed guests. I was delighted to be asked to speak at today's inauguration to honor President Doran as the sixth president of Bay Path University. What an impressive history the school has. 125 years as a great university that focuses on women's education. So congratulations, President Doran, on this exciting anniversary campaign, Reimagining Possibility. And that's what we do at Girls Inc. too. Reimagine a bigger, bolder, fairer future for our students. We share so much with President Doran, your faculty and our students. They actually mentor. We have board members. I think I saw Jotty out there. They do such a great job. We have interns. We have staff members who are Bay Path alumni. So you do such great work, and we really value those connections. And thanks to all of you who continue to touch the lives of girls. Today, we join President Doran recognizing the need to nurture curiosity and support achievement. We all know that there are still great inequities in salaries, leadership roles, and advancement opportunities for women. And we both want to change that. We know that girls, and we actually have a couple here in the audience, are innately capable and powerful. But unfortunately, some of the barriers to success that impact girls who live in communities that lack access to resources are still there. So it's crucial, as we're being optimistic about the future, that girls get access to a stellar education. And that's what both of us are doing. We're changing the landscape of what's possible for each student, their family, and their workplace. And that's the idea. You know, clear that path, turn that record over, do the unexpected, and go for it. Be bold and bigger and smarter and make the world different and better. And speaking of bold and better and bigger and smarter, we actually have two teens. They have a little surprise for you, President Doran. We'd like to introduce Emmeline and Adriana, who have a surprise for President Doran. So come on up on the stage. Thank you. And they will be actually taking a Bay Path College course this summer, so.
I'm so happy to be here with you today. To all of you, I'm so thankful to be in this wonderful company of all this beautiful celebration. To President Doran, I wish you this special day of great memories. I know that you picked this song, so we want everybody to sing along and enjoy this great day as we celebrate this installation. Are we here today to celebrate? It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. Oh, it's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Look all around, there's nothing but blue skies.
thank you so much to Vanessa and our Bay Path students. It was incredible. I now invite Dr. Thomas Minella, faculty chair, to the podium to give greetings from the Bay Path faculty, and he will be followed by other members of the Bay Path community.
Thank you, Charlene. I can't follow that. One more time, please. Good morning, everybody. My name is Tom Minella, and I'm an associate professor of biology, a proud member of the faculty at Bay Path University, and chair of that faculty. It is my honor to stand here today and represent those faculty and program directors for this momentous occasion. On behalf of them all, it is my pleasure to offer a warm welcome and congratulations to President Sandy Doran. This celebration of inauguration is about change, transition, and a hopeful future, but it is also about growth and sustainability. The metaphor of learning as a harvest is familiar to any educator. We plant seeds of knowledge, our students as learners blossom. But what is often lost in that metaphor is the role of the farmer. Our president is the steward of that farm. You plan each growing season and oversee each bountiful harvest. President Doran, your predecessor took a small garden and grew it into the great farm that you now inherit. And while the future weather may be uncertain, we have indeed made it to another spring and a season of new beginnings. Our ground is rich and fertile, and the seeds are sown. As you have already seen, our students, our Bay Path seeds, are among the most inspiring and teeming with potential. And this Bay Path earth in which they are now planted is among the most nourishing. Every day we see them flourish, and we are amazed and energized by their growth. President Doran, this land is now yours. And its seeds are your charge, and its workers, faculty, and staff are your partners, as are our Bay Path alumni, trustees, and supporters who will be with you in this endeavor. Your faculty and program directors stand ready to tend this land and work it to its fullest. We remain eager to see the harvest that you bring in and how you can help us all reimagine this field. President Doran, we remain excited to partner with you and your administration in support of our university mission, and for continued engagement in shared governance to ensure transparency and academic strength, and to strive to provide our students with the most exceptional learning experience possible. On behalf of the Bay Path faculty and program directors, happy spring, best wishes for a bountiful season of growth and prosperity, carpe diem, and congratulations on your inauguration as the head of this great university as we celebrate our 125th anniversary. It is now my sincerest pleasure to invite Julia Dudek to the podium. Thank you.
Dzień dobry, guests, fellow students, faculty, staff, and most importantly, President Doran. My name is Julia Dudek. I am a junior undergraduate pre-dental student at Bay Path University. I am honored to stand here before you today as the president of the Bay Path's Student Government Association. On behalf of the undergraduate students at Bay Path, I bring you warm greetings. Whenever I see President Doran, she is always elbow bumping every student as she passes by to enthusiastically greet them. This gesture emphasizes the content of her kind-hearted character and her commitment to forming interpersonal connections with the students in the Bay Path community. She never hesitates to stop whatever she is doing, whether it be making her way to the next meeting, grabbing lunch, or simply going for a stroll with Gracie Lou Freebush, her iconic white poodle that every student adores, including me. Last year, I was one of the students who found herself sitting alongside President Doran during one of her weekly fireside chats. At the time, Bay Path students gathered around a bonfire in front of Blake Student Commons to warm up and munch on some s'mores, while having the opportunity to connect with our president during a time when the world felt so disconnected. Myself, along with other students who came from far and wide, would attend these fireside chats. Each of us came with different aspirations, such as becoming future teachers, doctors, interior designers, advocates, or as in my case, dentist. I would spend time talking to President Doran about my past experiences, my current roles, and my future aspirations. Knowing that my priorities lie in one day becoming a dentist, President Doran connected me with the right faculty members on campus to allow me to branch out into the Longmeadow community in an effort to find my internship. It is my driven nature that got me to where I am today, but it is the support that BayPath University provides which has propelled me and a multitude of other students to meet our unique aspirations. Last semester, I am proud to say that I completed my 6-month internship at Flagship Dental. There, I was able to immerse myself in the field of dentistry, learning about the techniques, procedures, skill sets, and protocols involved in, to ensure a healthy smile at the end of the day. I can honestly say one of the most fundamental qualities President Doran and I share is our commitment to our visions. I have a vision to empower people through dentistry. President Doran has a vision to empower students through her outstanding leadership. President Doran, I have seen you work your magic these past 2 years, and I know you will continue to guide BayPath through whichever hardships or triumphs the future may bring. We welcome your visions and opportunities for growth with open arms. I would now like to introduce Christina Carpenter, the representative from the students from the American Women's College. Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. Hello, and greetings to you all as we welcome President Doran at the beginning of a new chapter in BayPath's illustrious history. My name is Christina Carpenter, and I am a junior at the American Women's College. I would like to start this off by referencing some information that I heard recently. I was told about a story of President Doran's mother, who has a story very similar to my own. Her mother made the sacrifice that many women, such as myself, make in life. Often we are confronted with the choice to hold off on our own education or careers and put the needs of our families first. It's a difficult but necessary decision for women to have to make. But President Doran's mother enrolled in college as an adult learner after having children to become an educator. I find myself in this story because I am also an adult learner, mother, and I am hoping to become an educator as well. I say this with ease while I am talking to you, but I must share this hasn't been an easy experience. I enrolled at the American Women's College during the start of the pandemic. While I was navigating being an online college student, I was also meeting my future as a teacher with a period of uncertainty. I think we can all agree the field of education has drastically changed over the last 3 years. It leaves me wondering what is ahead for this career I have been working so hard for. However, my anxieties, although valid, have been eased with the help of my peers, instructors, and the community I have created at BayPath. My professors have encouraged me to use this shift in education as an opportunity to pursue parts of it that enticed me in the first place. The support has allowed me to think of my career in progressive ways. For example, I recently have been accepted into a fellowship with Google, where we discuss the importance of ethical technology and artificial intelligence. I never would have pursued this incredible opportunity if it wasn't for the support of the BayPath community. I was one of 20 students chosen from around the world to participate in this program. I credit my selection to the unique perspective I gained from the education courses at the American Women's College. I was chosen for this fellowship because I insisted at a spot on the table. Education is changing and my voice will be heard. And I have this community to thank for that. But my story is not unique. I am a student who is fortunate enough to be able to speak in front of you today. I would like to take a moment to think of the women in the American Women's College who are not able to be here with us today. Many of them live across the region and our country, but they all have this in common. They are caregivers, full-time employees. They are partners, and most importantly, they are inspiring. I want to take a moment to say, we see you. The sacrifices the students of the American Women's College have made over the last few years have not been in vain. We now embrace hope for our future. So President Doran, I thank you, and I thank your mother for paving the way for women like me. I would now like to welcome Nikki Burnett to the podium. Thank you.
Good morning. I bring you greetings on behalf of the graduate programs at Bay Path University. The most important lesson that I learned at Bay Path was just keep writing. In 2013, I was not where I wanted to be, where I should have been, or how I portrayed myself to be. I came to Bay Path in search of a program that I would feel legitimized me and provided the structure I needed to figure out where I was going to land in this world. And I knew that furthering my education was the key. That very same year, my dear friend had a recurrence of her cancer. I thought I can take care of her and keep up with my studies. I couldn't. I realized I needed to do what was most important, and that was take care of my friend. I wouldn't have a second chance at that. But Bay Path supported me with deep compassion when I came to the decision to withdraw from my program, and they gave me a second chance. All chapters are not good, but they are necessary, but just keep writing. After my friend's passing, I eventually harnessed their strength to restart my program. Bay Path was there to welcome me to write my next chapter with them, and so I did. And in 2018, I completed my bachelor's in leadership and organizational studies. Sometimes you have to put that book down for a bit, but be sure to pick it back up when you're ready and just keep writing. I picked that book up again, I did. And in May of 2021, I earned my master's in leadership and negotiation from Bay Path University. You won't always write a book in sequence or eloquently, but just keep writing, and I am. In October of 2021, I began yet another chapter in my book. I enrolled in a doctoral program at Bay Path, and in May of 2024, I will have successfully earned my Doctor of Education in higher Education and Organizational Studies. Thank you. Thank you to Bay Path for helping me to reimagine my possibilities. President Doran, I appreciate that it takes a very, very special person to become a college president. You are purposely jumping into a sea of unwritten and unfinished chapters, and you're going to help us all and guide us all to finish those chapters. I hope that today my words, in some small way, have helped to assure you that you're in the right place, in the right way, at the right time, and in the right book. President Doran, I welcome you, I congratulate you, and I support you in writing your next chapter here with us at Bay Path University. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, and I'm so very honored to introduce Ms. Ashley Pereira.
Greetings, saludos. I am Ashley Pereira. On this historic day, I am honored to be here on behalf of the staff of Bay Path University to welcome Attorney Sandra Doran as our sixth president of Bay Path University. In every way and every day, our staff keeps the university operational. We can be found in departments, programs, and administrative offices all over the campus. We work in human resources, advising, finance, the library, facilities, technology services, grounds, admissions, communications, marketing, the list goes on and on. We are dedicated to making Bay Path University as strong an institution as possible in order to better serve our students. Over the past year and a half, I've had the privilege of getting to know President Doran and her goals. On her first day as president, she established the President's Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Advisory Council. I was humbled when I was asked to serve as a member. Since the DEI Advisory Council's inception, the President has looked to us to be a sounding board. All of us have been witnesses to the events in our region and our country that have called for social justice and racial equality. At BayPath, President Doran has sought our guidance on not only how we can be there for our students during these times, but how to help our faculty and staff gain a greater understanding of how diversity, equity, and inclusion influences and shapes our community. President Doran's commitment to these principles was especially evident when all of the staff were invited to be a part of BayPath University's strategic planning process. All voices are encouraged. We are coming together as an inclusive community is principle one of the strategic planning process. In fact, all of us have been encouraged to lend our views, perspectives, and voices in many ways. As staff, we appreciate this invitation to contribute to the future of BayPath University and recognize that it has been President Doran who has made that possible. President Doran, we will hold up our part of the bargain. This past year, under President Doran's direction, a new vision statement for BayPath was established. BayPath's vision that every learner's dream of a better career, a richer life, and a brighter future will be realized not only applies to our wonderful students, but also to our amazing staff. I am proud to be a part of the BayPath community, not only as a member of the staff, but also as a twice alumna. I am a first-generation Latina who grew up in a modest home here in Springfield. I was proud of myself when I obtained my undergraduate degree from another women's college, but I never dreamed of being able to obtain a graduate degree. I am proof that BayPath not only invests in our students, but in our staff. I have been able to obtain not one, but two master degrees during my five-year career at BayPath. Employees of BayPath have always been encouraged to further their education, and I am proud to see President Doran has continued this commitment. On a personal note, I have witnessed her kindness, passion, and wisdom. I could go on and on. When she is on campus, I see it when she stops to talk to our students, faculty, and staff. Although it may be embarrassing to admit that I regularly have lunch at the dining hall because despite my degrees, my cooking skills are another story. But nonetheless, every time I eat at the dining hall and President Doran walks through that door, without fail, she stops to talk to our students, and without fail, she acknowledges myself and my fellow colleagues as well. So President Doran, on behalf of all the staff, bienvenida, welcome, and congratulations. I would now like to welcome Stephanie O'Leary.
Good morning, BayPath University community, distinguished guests, trustees, faculty, students, and alumni. My name is Stephanie O'Leary, and I am a three-time BayPath alumna and a proud first-generation college student. I have the distinct pleasure of serving as the BayPath University Alumni Association Council President and a member of the Board of Trustees. President Doran, I have the honor of sending greetings to you and the BayPath community on this historic day on behalf of our 16,000 BayPath alum worldwide. We represent every piece of BayPath's 125-year history. From BayPath Institute, founded steps away from where we are standing today, to BayPath Junior College, to the one-day program, to BayPath's evolution from college to university, we are a diverse group that represents BayPath's rich history. As alumni, we are part of the fabric that makes a BayPath education unique and special. We are accountants, physician's assistants, business men and women, occupational therapists, lawyers, and community leaders, to name a few. As we span the generations, in May 2022, over 800 new graduates will participate in commencement and join the ranks of BayPath alumni. They will be greeted in spirit by our oldest living alumna, Vanessa O'Brien. Vanessa graduated from BayPath Institute in 1938. An incredible supporter of this university, I know her, and she does not act her age. When Vanessa was in her 90s, She walked the Great Wall of China with our students on a Capitals of the World trip. Vanessa will turn 103 on May 5th. Bay Path has also uniquely impacted all of our lives. Some of us took our first airplane ride on a Capitals of the World trip. Some of us returned to school to fulfill a lifelong dream of a college education. And like me, some of us found our voice inside the classroom and through the opportunities that Bay Path afforded us. One thing is for certain, the university has left an indelible mark on all of us. President Doran, we welcome you to our Bay Path family, and we are so excited to see where our university is headed in the future. As alumni, we know for certain that Bay Path will continue to be a leader in our next 125 years. We will hold true to preparing students for an ever-changing workforce while supporting our students' dreams of a college education. As a representative for our alumni, know that you can count on us. And know this, the best is yet to come. Congratulations on your inauguration. As the president of the Alumni Association, it is my honor to introduce the singing of the Bay Path Alma Mater by our students. They will be accompanied by the brass quintet. In recognition of Bay Path's 125th anniversary, a new third stanza written by Robert James Tomasulo, our director of musical activities, will be heard for the first time today.
That was just beautifully done. I know the words, but I wouldn't want to destroy the beautiful sound. Anyway, it's my pleasure to welcome Margaret McKenna, President Emeriti of Lesley University and mentor to Sandra Doran, and she will give the inaugural address.
Well, good morning. I am thrilled to be here. Actually, I'm thrilled to be anywhere there are human beings. Real people you can see who are dressed. It's been so long, and I am so pleased to be here to celebrate my friend Sandy Doran. And to celebrate with so many friends, and to be on the stage with the mayor and the dean of our congressional delegation, to see faculty and students and Sandy's family, to be in this part of the state, which I love, which holds my two grandchildren. And Sandy, you will see soon, this is the best part of your life to come. And I am so pleased to be at this institution to celebrate soon the first Black woman justice of the Supreme Court. I cannot think of an institution better than this one to celebrate Justice Brown Jackson's appointment. For 125 years, this institution has transformed the lives of women and continues to do so in ways we heard today from so many of them. Listen to the stories of Christina and Nikki today. Listen to those stories. And those are two stories. You heard from many of the women who graduated and who work here and who went here. And this institution for 125 years has provided that foundation, that basis, that encouragement, that transformation for women. So needed 125 years ago and so needed today. Those barriers still exist. And we need that encouragement. We need those models. We need those Carol Learys. We need those Sandra Dorans. We need those faculty members who provide that encouragement and expectation that yes, you can. Yes, you can. And yes, you need to be prepared for the barriers that still exist. I want you to know I take full credit for Sandy Doran. Yes, her mother, I acknowledge, is due a lot of that credit. But I personally convinced Sandy to leave the corporate world for higher education, to leave the well-resourced corporate world for the slightly less resourced world of higher education. It's like leaving a Mercedes for a Honda Civic. You might say it was the first of some of her unusual and maybe questionable, though courageous, choices. She chose to become a president at an unusual time. She chose to follow a long-term and what I call a second founder president, my friend Carol Learys. Now, I was also that kind of a president. I was a president in 22 years who also transformed an institution. Let me tell you how amazing it is to be like Carol and me. When we are gone, it's like we're dead and we're being eulogized. No one remembers the bad things. And everyone remembers the good things. I was on the campus a couple of years after I left, and walking down the hallway was a faculty member who disagreed with everything I did. Everything. I sort of walked up to the wall to sort of, I didn't want to sort of be confronted once again. The faculty member ran up to me, put her arms around me. We missed you so much. We just, everything you did just set up for us for the future. We miss you. I can't tell you every day I think about you so fondly. I thought, my goodness, she's had a breakdown. What is going on? Enter the new guy now following the saint. It is a very difficult place to be, and I love Carol, and she is a saint, and I'm a saint, too. But it's a very difficult proposition to follow a long-term, wonderful president, as Carol and I, we're both wonderful presidents. Sandy, you chose also to come, you and COVID. You know, it's impossible. You come as a new president. What's the first thing you do? You go meet and greet everyone. You shake their hand. You have to see them and touch them. Tell them who you are. They've got to see you. They've got to see what kind of person you are. After you've been here 6 months, Sandy goes to actually meet someone in person, and somebody says to her, gee, I thought you were taller. Because they've only seen her on video. They have no idea, really. You know, you can't, it's hard to tell the true gestalt of someone on video. I mean, Sandy's personality is warm and wonderful and outgoing and genuine. And you get that on video, but you only get a percentage of it. So it's a real disadvantage to come into an institution as you come with COVID. So it's challenging. I too made a choice like Carol did as she walked out and COVID came in. I left Leslie in 2007. Remember what happened in 2008? The economic downturn. So Sandy came at challenging times, but if there is anyone who is prepared to take on challenges and has the expertise and the experience, the knowledge, and the passion for this job and this particular place, because it's the right person at the right time, is Sandy Doran. You know, the college presidency today is complex. There's no clear answers. There's a lot of gray. These jobs are wonderful, impossible. It's a cross between a mayor, a hotel manager, a rabbi, a motivator, a visionary leader. She has such varied experience, and she has the right kind of values and the incredible will to excel. Most importantly, she really cares about students. I have no question that every decision Sandy makes, she will say, what is the best thing for students? No matter what that issue is, I know Sandy. You know, there are college presidents who really don't like students. I know you will find that hard to believe. Well, you know, not like it's maybe strong, but it's true, but who don't particularly like spending time with students. Sandy loves students and likes them. She likes to hang out with them, and she wants their lives to be better. So if somebody brings up an issue about curriculum or buildings or what to do with extra money, is there ever any extra money? No. She will say, what's the best things for students? You know what, Leslie, Sandy was involved in every decision we made, and we had some challenging times. She headed some unusual projects. We bought a church, a historic church, and we moved that church down the street. I literally lifted it up and moved it down the street. We condominiumized a divinity school. I don't want to make all the religious people nervous here that Sandy led the efforts to buy churches and condominiumize divinity schools, but she handled a lot of complex issues. You know, she's an expert in tech. She's an entrepreneur. She talks about things like stackable classes and credential upskilling. She's done partnerships and provided unusual opportunities for students. She has a long history of supporting women, and she cares a lot for families. She listened. She's a great listener. A lot of people do not listen. You think they're listening, but they're not listening. They're being polite. Sandy actually listens, and she's willing to change when she learns something new. She cares about people, not only ones she knows, but she cares about the common good. She cares about fairness and justice and social justice. She's a good friend, a true friend. And I think, most importantly, she's really fun. This is a good place. 125 years. It's the kind of place today that is so important. It cares about transforming lives. It cares about first-generation students. It cares about the professions that are desperately needed today in our communities. It cares about community, the community of our students and the communities we serve and their needs. She's the right person at the right time. And a college president said that working in education means that one always continues to listen and learn. And that college president, who I'm quoting, is Sandy Doran, your new president of this institution. You are lucky to have her.
Thank you, Dolores, for that beautiful performance. I'm going to add a bit of trivia to the celebration. You can write down your answers, hand them in on the way out. There was one person here, well, maybe more than one, but one that I know of, who was awarded a scholarship to Southern Methodist University to study the viola. And in case that's not enough of a hint, that person is also our sixth Baypath University president. So that performance was very meaningful. But despite rumors, that's not why we asked Sandy to be the president of Baypath University. When Dr. Leary came to the board and let us know of her plans to retire, we wiped away a few tears. We took a few deep breaths, and Pat Pierce, my good friend and who was the chair of the board at that time, Pat and I got together and said, we got some work to do. So we pulled together a team, students, faculty, deans, other board members, and we said, all right, let's get to work. Now, I think those of you who sort of follow higher ed, being in the higher ed business right now is challenging, and those friends who joined from other universities are probably nodding their heads right now. By the way, representatives and leadership from other universities, thank you for being here with us today. It's very meaningful to have you here. But as you know, being in this business is challenging it right now. Being an institution of our size with our mission is even more challenging. So we knew we needed a leader who could lead us through those challenging times when we hit them, but while also setting a vision for the future and helping us create a strategy for the future. We needed a leader who would continue to be a disruptor, who was comfortable being a disruptor. We have a reputation for being innovative. We embrace our size. We want to take advantage of it to be nimble. And we needed a leader who could continue that legacy to be a disruptor and help us reimagine the future of higher education. We needed a leader who would aggressively help us form partnerships with other universities, with businesses, with the public sector, both locally and nationally. And let's be clear, the future of higher education, the tight connection between those organizations, higher ed, public sector, and the private sector is critical to the future of higher education. We needed a leader who would embrace our core values. We needed a leader who, most importantly, had a genuine passion for our students, who would recognize them for who they are, would embrace them, and would be inclusive to make sure that they feel fit and set in our institution. And I'm talking about all of our students, our traditional undergraduate students, our adult women learners, our men and women in our graduate programs, but understand each of their unique needs and make sure that our institution continue to serve them in the way that they need to be served. So you bundle all that together, and that's no easy find. But we did it. We did it, and we found Sandy Doran. And that's why I am super excited and privileged to install Sandy as our sixth Baypath University president. So to begin the official investiture, I ask Sandra Doran, the sixth president of Baypath University, Stephen Doran, presidential spouse, and Carol Leary, president emerita, to join me at the podium. You'll know your place. That is a picture right there. As described in the inauguration program, a symbol of the office of the president is presented to the president during the inauguration ceremony, a presidential medallion. Once the president receives this symbol, it is worn over the academic gown on public occasions, particularly at commencement. The official ceremonial mace is the emblem of academic authority and rich in symbolism. Now, through the power invested in me by the BayPath University Board of Trustees and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I will administer the oath of office to the sixth president of BayPath University, Sandra J. Doran. The BayPath University mission states, a BayPath University education empowers undergraduate women and graduate women and men to become leaders in their careers and their communities with an innovative approach to learning that prepares students to flourish in a constantly changing world. Do you, Sandra Doran, solemnly swear to support and further the mission of BayPath University during the term of your presidency?
I do.
Congratulations.
Wow. First of all, I want to thank our amazing students who spoke this morning, who sang this morning, who created that extra version of our alma mater to celebrate BayPath today. So please join me in thanking them. Please stand. Thank you, Jonathan, the Board of Trustees, for bestowing this honor. Thank you for the privilege of leading this great institution. Friends, before I begin my remarks, I'd like to bring us back for just a moment to that beautiful rendition of our national anthem performed by BayPath students. One line in particular stands out: the land of the free, the home of the brave. Now I'd like to ask you to think about the first line of another national anthem that is being heard around the world. The glory and freedom of Ukraine has not yet perished. If we could please pause for one moment and think about our Ukrainian sisters and brothers, universities, our Ukrainian students, as well as others and families. Please join me. Thank you. Now I'd like to ask Carol Leary to join me at the podium. Carol, just when you thought. Carol, I want to thank you for your vision, determination to grow BayPath into its place as one of the strongest, most entrepreneurial, most innovative colleges in America. I proudly stand on your shoulders and am humbled by your accomplishments of the past 25 years, recognizing that every step of this next leg of our journey is possible because of the path that you created. Thank you, Carol.
Thank you.
Margaret McKenna, thank you for being a wonderful mentor and friend, and for your unconditional support. And to my cadre of wise women who are here, thank you for your support and guidance. Thank you to my family and friends for supporting me through this incredible journey. My mother, Sally, is here, my father, Dick, and stepmom, Linda. My daughter, Dana, son, Adrian, you've met my daughter-in-law. You've met my granddaughter, who will be in the class of 2040, so think about that. Think about that. My family, Christy and Joe, Shannon and Steve, David and Ian, Joe and Barb, and our friends who are here to support us. Steve and I say thank you. And to my husband, Steve. I'm fine. Who has supported me and our family in all of our adventures. Leading a college through change requires the commitment of both partners. And I promise you, in this room, all of you, that his commitment runs as deep as mine. To Congressman Neal, to Mayor Sarno, to Town Manager Simmons, thank you. Honored guests who worked tirelessly for the betterment of our communities. Thank you for being here with us today to celebrate BayPath. To BayPath faculty and staff who embraced me even as they could not see me, who supported me even as they were navigating their own challenges with the pandemic, what could be more consequential than preparing our students to make smarter, more informed decisions? For you, for your support and trust, I am deeply grateful. To my colleagues here in the hall representing sister institutions, thank you for honoring BayPath. Your presence is important. The diversity of the institutions you represent provides a plethora of choices for our higher education students. Women's colleges, research institutions, community colleges, neighboring colleges, we provide opportunities for students from all circumstances to pursue their academic and career interests. To our musicians and speakers who have made this day and our volunteers such a special and memorable one, thank you. And to our students, the future belongs to you. Carpe futurum. Friends, my roots are in education. My maternal great-great-grandparents were among the 2.1 million who left Ireland during the famine of 1945. Like so many of our immigrants who leave their homelands in search of a better life, who arrive on our shores and add to the rich and beautiful diversity of our nation, my great-great-grandparents set out to reimagine new possibilities for themselves and their children. They arrived in Canada and settled in Colorado, rural Colorado. I guess of all, Colorado was probably rural at that point. My great-grandfather was an itinerant teacher going from town to town, gone for weeks, while my grandmother stayed home raising five children in this one-room house. Now, this picture was taken in 1966. It is the exact same house, plus electricity, is the only improvement since 1900. My great-great-grandparents arrived in Colorado driven by a personal mission to educate pioneers and their children. My grandfather moved to a town outside New York City and became the superintendent of schools, and my mother, who you've heard about, returned to school to finish her degree after 20 years to become a music teacher. It is extraordinary what an openness to growth and change can mean in one's life. Thinking of change, there's very interesting data showing that today's students will have 17 job changes and work in five different industries in the course of their lifetime. Think about that. And our role is to make sure they're prepared. Thomas Merton, the writer, theologian, poet, and social activist said, "You do not need to know precisely what is happening or exactly where it is all going. What you need is to recognize the possibilities and challenges offered by the present moment and to embrace them. Embrace them with courage, faith, and hope. And isn't that what education is all about? Courage, faith, and hope. Now, we've all learned how important it is to live in a world of ambiguity, possibilities, and embrace them. It's what we ask of our students every day, and what we, as educators in higher education, faculty, staff, demand of ourselves at BayPath. Friends, today we are here to celebrate an institutional milestone for our institution, for our students, and for our community. And reimagining possibility for our institution and our students has been at the heart of many milestones in our BayPath history, like the creation of our one-day-a-week Saturday program for adult women, which evolved into the American Women's College, a robust online student experience. It was designed to provide access to a high-quality education for underserved women. This program provides women, many of whom work full-time while raising children, often as single mothers, with the opportunity to achieve a degree when so many other avenues have been denied to them. This model taps into the unrealized aspirations of adult women, providing them with the skills, the education, most importantly, the confidence they need to reimagine their own lives. What is as true now as has been throughout our history is our steadfast commitment and core promise of providing innovative, career-focused programs in response to the economic, social, and technological influences of our time. But it wasn't only technology that inspired us to innovate, it was hope. The hope we hold deep in our hearts and that ignites our vision. That at BayPath, every learner's dreams of a better career, a richer life, a brighter future will be realized. We have 3,400 students at BayPath, and I'd like to share with you a couple stories of hope and change. This is the hope that Clarencia Lawrence had when she enrolled at BayPath to pursue her RN to BSN degree. Throughout her journey to graduation, she balanced a full-time job, family, studies. Her job was working as a nurse in a COVID unit. Her family included her husband and two children. Her studies were in the wee hours of the night, the early hours of the morning, and yet she maintained a GPA of 3.7 and made the dean's list every term right up through graduation last year. Throughout it all, she volunteered on weekends to participate in outreach and community programs. We do what we do because of students like Clarencia. In the year 2000, we launched our co-educational graduate school with the same commitment to providing innovative, career-focused programs, including those to fill workforce demands that were unknown just a few years ago, like genetic counseling, cybersecurity. Our programs also address societal needs, as in education, health sciences. Omar Irizarry, regional director of the Gandara Center right here in Springfield, is a current student at BayPath's Master of Science in Nonprofit Management Program and will graduate next May. Born in Puerto Rico, Omar moved to the United States when he was 6 years old. He attended Holyoke Community College, then went on to earn his bachelor's at Elms College, and we are now proud to call him a BayPath graduate student. The fluidity of the careers of our students is evidenced by the fluidity of their educational paths. In many ways, the pandemic caused us all to reimagine possibility. At BayPath, because of the remarkably innovative technology infrastructure we had built over the years to serve students, we were prepared to transition to a robust and effective online learning approach, and our students continue to thrive. I think of Carly Stenhart, who experienced half, 2 years, of her undergraduate years through COVID. Undaunted, she persevered. She adapted to the new model. She's a biology major, senior class president, rugby player, and member of the Student Athletic Advisory Committee. Clarice will graduate this May and go on to graduate school at Vanderbilt University. Now, while this transition to robust online learning was accomplished at BayPath, we knew this was not universal, and we recognized the devastating impact the impact was having on younger students, elementary age students, middle school students. Perhaps no one recognized this more than Dr. Jennifer Stratton, BayPath's Associate Professor of Education. When the pandemic hit in the spring of 2020, Professor Stratton was teaching reading instruction fundamentals to her BayPath education students. Halfway through the semester, however, that focus took on a new direction as schools everywhere were forced to close down. Children were left without teachers, parents found themselves moonlighting as educators, and Dr. Stratton's education students were left without a classroom to teach in. Faced with this new reality, Dr. Stratton reimagined possibility. To her, the solution was simple: start your own virtual school. 7 days later, 1 week, the Stratton School was up and running and online, serving kids in 5 states with literacy lessons taught by BayPath students. We all recognize the challenges of the pandemic. Each one of us likely experienced moments of fear, loneliness, pain. But how, as Merton would ask us, can we recognize the possibilities and embrace them with courage, faith, and hope? How can we translate what we have witnessed, observed, and learned, translate it into a kinder, more empathetic, and joyous future? What have we learned as organizations, as individuals, as institutions? From my perspective, we have learned that we need each other more than ever. We are not meant to be isolated in dark silence. We are wired to connect, to feel our humanity. This was so clearly evident just last Friday as we welcomed over 1,400 people to our 25th annual Women's Leadership Conference. It has been 3 long years since we were able to convene this convent, and it inspired me like no other. Like the awakening of spring, the Women's Leadership Conference gave us optimism and light. One attendee said to me, "BayPath is not a place. BayPath is not just an institution or a university. Yes, it is all those things, but it is a movement that inspires us all to reach higher." Focused on the future well-being of man and womankind, we must not only emerge from this worldwide health crisis, we must also reckon with unprecedented social justice challenges. We must strive for the common good, as we've talked about. What is our responsibility to each other and to those we serve? At BayPath, this responsibility is articulated through our values. At the core of our community is a firm commitment to diversity, equity, inclusion, and belonging. These core values are the wellspring for our innovation and growth. By actively seeking and embracing different perspectives and ideas through open-mindedness and intentional conversation, we are ensuring that our work will remain relevant, relevant to the needs of our students, employers, and lifelong learners. Our values are also manifest in treating others with respect and compassion, in working together collaboratively, and attending to the health and well-being of our entire community. Friends, the underlying value, fundamental to BayPath, is that we share in our belief that our learners always come first. You've heard today, being student-centered is our mission. It is our passion. And we champion these students to achieve extraordinary things, and they do. Think about the students you heard from today. At BayPath, our charge is to prepare students for the unknowable, for problems unseen, for careers yet imagined. We are preparing them and ourselves for the ambiguity of the world that we live in, and a lifetime of new possibilities, equipping us all with the skills and confidence to be successful. Here at BayPath, every learner's dreams of a better career, a richer life, a brighter future will indeed be realized. This is our shared vision. And as president of BayPath, I promise you my unwavering commitment and tireless effort in support of this vision. So acting on this vision is our responsibility and our joy. Let us move forward together with the courage to do what is right, with faith in ourselves, each other, and our future, and with unbridled hope and joy for ourselves, our communities, and our students. I am so thrilled and privileged to be part of this great university, to be going on this great and wonderful journey with you. In the spirit that binds us all, carpe diem, and carpe futurum.
Please join me in congratulating Sandra Doran, the sixth president of BayPath University. I have known all six. And this concludes our ceremony. I want to thank all who have joined on this historic occasion. And may I ask you to please stand for the benediction to be delivered by Tanya Barber, BayPath University trustee and member of the MBA class of 2009. And at the end, at the close of the blessing, please remain standing. At your seat to allow the platform parties, special guests, trustees, delegates, and faculty to process out of the hall. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations, President Doran. Isn't this a beautiful, beautiful occasion that we all were able to come together and celebrate and unite together as one? But how many of you know there's a scripture that says that with man, things are impossible, but with God, all things are possible. So at this time, we are going to invoke heavens. We're going to go before the throne room, and I'm asking for us all to bow our heads and let us all unite together in prayer. Heavenly Father, eternal Almighty God, thou from whom all blessings flow, we thank you for this celebration as we transition from this part of BayPath's inaugural historical moment of appointing its sixth president. We humbly thank you for the calling of President Sandra Doran for such a time as this, a time to lead BayPath through a time of rejuvenation and restoration, a time of refreshing and reviving. And while earlier we were praying for the rain to go away, Lord, I'm praying for you to send your abundance of rain as an outpouring of your grace and your mercy, which are new every day. Extend your glory and favor upon President Doran, Stephen Doran, their family, and the BayPath family, students, faculty, staff, and Board of Trustees, as we move forth in this season of reimagining the possibilities with passion and purpose. In this season of reimagining, may those under President Doran's leadership know that to reimagine is not a rejection of the past traditions or a repudiation of present trends, but rather a seeking to go beyond, looking over the horizon of impossibilities, transforming the challenges into possibilities, embracing the problems as they come because they all have an answer. We pray, Father, that through the lens of courage, hope, and faith, that you cover President Doran with renewed strength. We pray for President Doran to mount up with wings as eagles. Let her run the race set before her and not be weary. Let her walk with endurance and not faint. Let her dreams and vision spring forth, renewed ideas to reinvigorate, regenerate, and recreate. Amen.
Thank you.